So as hard as myself and many of the Halo Infinite multiplayer community have been regarding Halo Infinite, there is some good news finally. And I wanted to do a quick video today talking a little bit about it and I think what it means ultimately for where Halo Infinite multiplayer is going, and a shout out to the multiplayer team on Halo that at least they realize now, hey, this is not right, and they have been making positive changes to remedy it. So a lot of you guys don't follow the Reddit or the Discord or all of the social media channels as well as I do. So I saw this pop a couple hours ago and I thought I would do a quick video on it talking about it. So this is on the official Halo subreddit. It is called Playlist Update and it is from Sketch. So Sketch is one of the Halo community managers. He primarily focuses on the Reddit side of things. And then John Unishek focuses mostly on the Twitter side of things. I'm going to read it in its entirety. Hey, everyone. Last weekend, I said I'd be back once we have updates to share around near-term playlist plans for Halo Infinite. I'm happy to report that a Slayer playlist is officially locked and loaded for next week. So real quick, as a time out there, the playlists update every Tuesday. This is when the any new changes would occur in terms of your weekly pass progression. If you've completed the weekly, you'll get a whole set of new challenges. If you hadn't, too bad, you'll get a whole set of new challenges. But Tuesday is kind of the official start of the Halo competitive week. There will be four new playlists: Slayer, Fiesta, Free For All, and SWAT, which will all be added on Tuesday, December 14th. As I noted last week, the team's original plans for a Slayer playlist include a variety of new variants that weren't going to be ready in time to deploy before the holiday break. To address player feedback for Slayer in the near term, we will be releasing a basic Slayer offering to start with, and we will look to bolster and expand it with more variants in a future update. Next week's update will also include adjustments to challenges, including removing some particularly frustrating mode-specific ones, reducing some requirements for others, making weekly ultimate challenges less intensive because getting there is tough enough, and adding brand new challenges specific to challenge playlists. Personally, I'm eager to check out the new challenge category that's based on accumulating player score. This is a small step towards our performance-based experience. We'll have more details to share on Halo Waypoint next week. Lastly, on a semi-related note, please note that the team is aware and is actively investigating reports of intermittent hiccups affecting some players and big team battle over the last few days. Additionally, the team is continuing to review ranked matchmaking and player feedback around potential anomalies. Thank you to everyone who has shared constructive feedback and filed support tickets for issues you're running into. More to come, and have a great weekend. And he's got a ton of upvotes and awards, and everybody's ecstatic, and I'm ecstatic, and everybody should be. This is great, great news. So let's unpack a little bit of this so you kind of understand where this is going to go. First and foremost, Slayer will become a playlist again. Right now, the only playlists you have available are the bot playlist, where you play against bots. Typically, unless a challenge says in PvP associated with it, you can grind out bot challenges to complete these challenges. We also have the standard arena playlist, which includes all variants: Slayer, Strongholds, Capture the Flag, Oddball, and then you have the big team battle mode as well. Problem is, as many of you guys have run into, I know I have, that you have challenges that are specific towards doing Slayer kills or are specific doing some sort of unique challenge, as in Capture the Flag in only, obviously, Capture the Flag mode, or to defend three Strongholds, obviously only available in Strongholds. The way the game is kind of designed right now is you don't have access to that. Now, unfortunately, this update will not yet fix that. There is not going to be a playlist that's just Oddball. There's not going to be a playlist that's just Capture the Flag. However, a lot of people want just a Slayer playlist, not just because Slayer is the most popular mode and some people just want to have that fun experience. And that's, I mean, you think of Call of Duty and most other competitive shooters, it's pretty much just get the first amount of kills over somebody else. But additionally, SWAT is another big one too. And there are a lot of challenges that, in my opinion at least, and this is somebody who's gone through all the battle passes to completion, or at least I shouldn't say the battle passes, the weekly challenges each week, I've done all of them. there are definitely playlists that favor one particular type of weapon over another. Starting with a battle rifle, for example, in a certain mode is a competitive advantage than having to run over to a weapon rack and trying to find it. One, hoping that the map actually has one. Two, hoping that somebody didn't take it. It's a compound issue that if you're trying to get through challenges, it's on a very specific set of circumstances. You got to be in a good team that's willing to do the challenge with you. You have to be able to get the right weapons or the right equipment that you need in order to complete the challenge. And then you have to have enough skill to actually pull it off. So I think the playlist piece of that is going to solve a big part of it. The fact that Fiesta is coming back is awesome. It's always been a fun mode. And I think the original concern that 343 had was, hey, look, we have far too many people who may scatter. We want to keep the playlist down. I don't think that's an issue in a free-to-play game, and I think they've probably realized that. They have talked a lot in the past about kind of cannibalizing one specific playlist in exchange for another. If you added Slayer, their original concern, if we added a Slayer playlist, it's going to take away from the objective modes. Well, I think the hook right now with the weekly challenges that need to be done, you still will have a decent population scattered across the board. Of course, if it looks like matchmaking is taking too long and you're trying to queue for, let's just say, SWAT, and there's not a lot of people playing SWAT with you on a specific day, well, unfortunately, you're going to sit and wait. This is something I saw a lot of on Halo 5 Guardians, especially the Warzone mode, which I loved. Warzone Assault particularly, it died off very quickly. So I loved playing Warzone Assault at launch. It died off so much so they actually removed it, and now they bring it back occasionally as like a weekend event. So this is good news. The other part of this too is now the challenges have changed. They said that they're adding brand new challenges. So they have admitted, and Sketch has admitted in my last video I did where we read through his massive post, he talked a lot about challenges that he was doing that he was not a particular fan of, like getting 10 skewer kills or getting a sniper rifle shot, no scope, or something like that. That's like, wow, that is an incredibly specific set of circumstances that really forces you to play a very specific way in order to meet all those challenges. Sounds like 343 has been taking a lot of feedback, and we're going to start weeding out some of those other playlists, which does make sense. And I would suspect you will see new ones included. Maybe now play 3 matches of Slayer or Fiesta or play a free-for-all match or something along those lines. I could expect to see some of that feeding in. The other really nice thing that they changed is the ultimate challenge. So after you complete your regular playlist as normal and you've completed all of the objectives for the week, you will get a final single new objective. Now, this list has leaked in the past. It's very readily available. Probably doesn't mean much now, but a lot of those challenges are very grindy. Last week was the 117, which is to win 17 matches. Win 17 matches, not compete in them, win 17 matches. Or to get a, 50 melee kills or something along those lines. It sounds like they're going to drop that down significantly to make it a little bit easier. Because as Sketch does say, the grind getting there is challenging enough for sure. So you shouldn't be punished for getting through the entire list of challenges only to have some other challenge that takes almost as long as the previous challenges to get there. So that's a really positive thing. And then lastly, the other piece here that I was really, really excited about was that they said they're working towards a performance-based experience. So this is something that we have all been frustrated and struggling with. I suspect you'll see a challenge now that says get 10 kills in a match. Or so I specifically say player score. So I'm guessing the challenge may be specifically get 5 kills and 5 assists or something along those lines in a match, which will chip away at the challenges. All this data that does feedback, and I'll close out with this, all this data that does feedback into their database, they are actively looking at which challenges are completed, which ones are skipped, and etc. Now, if you're a conspiracy theorist, as many of us have slowly become on Reddit, you may say, hey, wait a minute. They're clearly going to stack the deck towards challenges that are hard to do because they want you to buy challenge swaps and they want you to buy the double XP tokens to grind through and grind around some of these other challenges. I am still somewhat convinced of that myself personally. I know Sketch has been very clear that was never an intention. I don't necessarily believe it. I think there's a lot of shady business practices out there and it wouldn't put past anyone. The microtransaction system in this game is incredibly predatory. It's incredibly overexpensive. The $1,000, the 1,000 Halo points, which is $10 US, to buy a very small cosmetic item versus what you get for your same $10 in Call of Duty or Apex is baffling. So it does make sense that the challenge system is still a little stacked. However, the fact that 343 is actively looking at this and removing difficult challenges and maybe potentially easing off on some of the challenges that players aren't able to complete, or at least ones that they're swapping a lot, I could see this both ways. Like I said, there's a conspiracy theory part of me, but there's also a part of me that says, hey, they're acknowledging that some of these challenges suck. I think they're walking a fine line between being able to cater to a fan base and to keep the interest of the game up, as well as to make money. There is a fine line there. If you gave everybody everything for free, you would have tons of players but no money. If you do the system where everything is heavily monetized, you may have a lot of money but no players to buy it. So they're walking a fine line here. The game has only been out a very short time, and we've seen some significant radical changes. We're going to continue to see significant radical changes, and I think we'll probably end up as a compromise, not where 343's original vision was, not where the player's original vision was, but somewhere in the middle. And I'll take that. The fact that we can play six matches a day and we're guaranteed a level now, the fact that we will have a Slayer playlist, the fact that some of the challenges are being doped down in difficulty, these are all very positive, very wonderful changes, and I'm very, very thrilled for that. So stay tuned next week. We'll all dive into Slayer on Tuesday, December 14th. We'll check out the new challenges. If I need to do another video or some other major update, I will at that point. I know a lot of Halo content's been dominating this channel, but as you guys know, Halo is my absolute favorite franchise. So, of course, when I see this stuff, I want to talk about it, and I want to get the message out there, number one. And number two, I want to express some positivity for once on 343 and say, hey, guys, attaboy, you did good. I'm glad you're updating your stuff. That's it for today's video. Thank you all so much for watching. Take care of yourselves, and until next time, I will see you guys on the other side.